टुडे विल डिस्कस द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ डब्ल्यू बाय एल रेशियो फॉर गिवन सीमॉस इम्प्लीमेंटेशन. सो हियर बुलियन एक्सप्रेशन इज गिवन ए बी सी प्लस डी. दिस बुलियन एक्सप्रेशन इज गिवन एंड वी हैव टू इम्प्लीमेंट दिस बाय यूजिंग सीमॉस लॉजिक एंड ऑल्सो यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट इट्स विड्थ टू लेंथ रेशियो फॉर एनमॉस एंड पीमॉस एंड अगेन यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट टोटल एरिया needed for that particular chip. So first we will implement this. So ABC plus D. So for pull-up network ABC, there is product in between this A, B and C. So that are connected in parallel. D is connected in series with this. Again, for full-down network ABC connected in series, D is with parallel. And as there is no hole bar over this, so we have connected here inverter. One inverter, again separate power supplies are there. Now in order to calculate its W by L ratio, you have to apply some rules for calculation of W by L ratio. Okay. So here we have to choose longest path for full up network. The path which is originating from power supply, that is a VDD, to output, that is a path for full up network. And path for full down network is from output to ground. So we have to choose longest path for pull up network and pull down network. Again, calculation of W by L for PMOSes, that means pull up network. So K is the W by L for PMOSes, and formalize R is equal to 2R by K plus 2R by K plus 2R by K and so on. Means number of MOSFETs. So according to that, this number increase or decrease. Again, calculation of W by L for pull down network. So again it is R by K plus R by K plus R by K and so on. In order to find the W by L ratio equivalent when the transistors are connected in series, so here 1 upon in bracket 1 by W by L of MOSFET 1 plus 1 by W by L of MOSFET 2. When that MOSFETs are connected in parallel and you have to find the equivalent of this, then simply addition of W by L ratio of individual MOSFET and total area needed on chip, that means W by L of pull up network and W by L of pull down network. So we have to apply these rules for that Boolean expression. So again, coming back to this numerical. Okay, so here this is a CMOS implementation. Now for pull up network, so here from VDD to output, so here output is there. So for VDD to output, there are multiple paths by which we can reach from VDD to output, like path AD, then BD and CD, and you have to choose longest path. So in every path there are two MOSFET. Okay, so we can choose any path. So two MOSFETs are required, like A and D, that two MOSFETs are required. So we have to find its W by L ratio. Okay, so this A and D, these are the two MOSFETs which are present in the longest path. So finding the W by L for pull up network, that is R is equal to 2R by K plus 2R by K. If we solve this, then we will get the W by L for PMOS is 4. Same way, finding the longest path in pull down network. Okay. So from this output to ground, there are two ways by which we can reach from this output to ground. One way is through ABC and another way is traversing through D only. As we have to choose longest path, so here we are choosing this path ABC. So in that ABC, 3 N MOSFETs are there. So this 3 N MOSFETs, so finding the W by L for pull down network, R is equal to R by K plus R by K plus R by K 3 times, because 3 N MOSFETs are there. If we solve this, then we will get a value of K is equal to 3, which is a W by L of N MOSFET. But here the value of 3 is for A, B and C. But as D is in parallel with this ABC, which are connected in series. So by using the rules for that W by L ratio, we have to find its equivalent when MOSFETs are connected in series. Okay, so if we solve by using that rule, then we will get the value of W by L for D is 1, we have to simply find the W by L for full up network and full down network, that is the total number of MOSFETs. So for full up network we have to multiply by the factor 3 because of the width variation of pull up network and pull down network. So here we are multiplying it by the factor 3. Then addition of this all W by L of PMOSes, so 4 plus 4 plus 4. And here one inverter is there, so for inverter it is always PMOS is 2 and NMOS is 1, again by using that rules for W by L. So if we add this and multiply the factor 3, then we will get here 54 W for pull up network. Same way for pull down network, 3 plus 3 plus 3 6, 9 plus 10 plus 1 11. Here no need of any multiplication factors, simply we have to do the addition up for pull down network. So this addition is 11. Now total area needed for the chip is width to length ratio of pull up network and width to length ratio of pull down network. If we do this addition, then we will get 54 plus 11, so 65W is the answer for this W by L ratio of given CMOS logic, which is Y is equal to ABC plus